Hello, martial arts journeymen and women. So it's been 2 weeks now that I'm in Portland training in the Wimp Warrior program in SBG Portland. And so far I'm really loving it. I loved it from the beginning and I would say I'm loving it even more. I mean, I'm becoming part of the community. I'm starting to also get to know people. The group is coming in together. Some people do not show up. Not everyone shows up. Sometimes some people skip the classes. Some just dropped out. So, but the ones who stayed, they're really nice. And slowly we're getting to know each other. There's that kind of a pack feeling building up. And yeah, and also within the gym, the people are really nice there. And I'm starting to get to know people personally and just starting to feel part of the community. So yeah, I'm really enjoying the whole experience. In the Wimp to Warrior program, we're still working on fundamentals. We worked specifically on the fundamentals of wrestling, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, and boxing. And it appears that the classes are more or less, that's how they're split up. And a lot of people ask me, so how are they organized? And I talked to Coach Rick about that, and it seems like it's like that. I think there's no rigid schedule, but there is a tendency that, well, basically we start with a warm-up, a nice good warm-up, then there's more or less of a theme. So it would be whether it's jiu-jitsu, whether it's wrestling, whether it's boxing, and then we do some cardio at the end and some theory, and we're good to go. As I said, also I tend to stay for at least one more extra class right after, where some of the amateur champions are training as well. So I'm not very much all the time there, being up to their level. But they're nice enough to train with me, and I really appreciate that. And I think that's one of the visions of SBG, that they're not separating people, they're not segregating people too much. You can train with the champs, and obviously, the exercises, they're picked up in a very intelligent way, so that whoever trains with them, that they would benefit from it, but also a person such as me with much less experience would benefit as well. But it's such a privilege to train with them, and I'm learning so much, and we did some sparring, and I'm finally starting to feel like I'm starting to feel it. I'm starting to, not saying I'm good at it at all, but I definitely don't look the same like I did in the Aikido versus MMA video. I'm starting to feel like I'm in it, and it's such an enjoyable feeling. You know, it's funny, I always felt, for a long time now, I felt that it almost felt like I'm going to be the guy who will never become good at MMA sparring. It's just like, it's like almost as if like I'm broken or something. But slowly the pieces are coming together, and it's such an enjoyable feeling to be able to do that, to know that I can do that too. So it's really enjoyable, and I'm happy to do that. And soon enough, in a week or so, I'm going to start recording my progress in sparring, so that's going to be fun too. Now, if you watch my recent videos, you know that I experienced a burnout. I believe it was a overtraining related to the fact that I jumped into training straight away, disregarding the travel and jet lag, although I was suggested to do differently by you guys. I'm sorry, I'm a bad person. But that happened nevertheless. But last week, yeah, I was struggling through the week. I was struggling in training, and I started talking about that, and you guys supported me very much. A lot of you wrote great comments. Just feeling your support already feels awesome. And also just some of you wrote really good ideas on how to kind of fix my mental game, so I wouldn't feel guilty if I don't go to some trainings, how to cut it down. And also I talked to my coach Vanessa, who's not only a former professional MMA fighter, but also a professional fitness coach and nutritionist. So she gave me some great advice there as well. So feeling all that support, that definitely boosted me, and I took Sunday off. I did a seminar on Saturday, which I regretted. I stayed for the second part. I was like, just like, not much use of me was there. I was just not capable of learning because I was too tired. But then Sunday, I took a good day's rest, and today I'm starting to feel like, I felt like I didn't overtrain, but I started to feel like I'm getting back there. Obviously, I did not need to make sure I don't rush in. I learned about, I think it's like called like unloading or something. I cannot exactly remember the term, but I watched some videos about overtraining, and one of the suggestions is to actually for a week to really, and Mohsin Lala, yes, you specifically suggested me that, but you didn't tell me about the science behind it. So yeah, that apparently if you like really make 1 week very easy, very light, statistically, based on science, based on experiments, your progress just boosts up way much. And there's this old mentality of, no, I have to train. It's all about training more. That makes you better. I'm learning it's not just about that. As some of you said, really good training has to be equated by really good rest. And if really good rest is not there, really good training is impossible. And I'm learning that. And I really appreciate that lesson. And that's my biggest lesson right now that I'm working on. And finally, I'm starting to see results. Obviously, I still need to work more. But yes, I'm very happy about that. I wanted to share that. So one more thing that I wanted to share in this video is related to the burnout, to the overtraining, it's related also to honesty. And my channel was for a long time now based on honesty. I'm all about just being open and seeing what's out there. And there's one thing which, for smart and good reasons, I was keeping away from you guys and girls for the last week or so. But the truth is, and I won't say too many details because it's not about just me, and I cannot talk about other people without them in the video. It's not fair. It's not nice. But I'll tell you enough so you understand what's happening. So back home, things are not so great in terms of my relationship. And it's not just because I came here. It didn't just start here. It started even before I came here, but then things are not going so well. And I realized in the beginning, I didn't want to admit it, but it definitely had a mental impact on me. And I think that's, as I looked into overtraining, the phenomenon of overtraining, the stress and mental aspect apparently plays a big role. If you have stress, if you have a lot of stress, and then you still train, that's where you just overtrain. And I realized probably that had to play a big part. And I'm slowly coming back to balance. I'm slowly getting out of it, out of that bad mood. And all things aside, I am feeling quite good right now. If things continue, I will definitely talk more about this. Again, I'm a public figure. You guys follow me. You've seen my wife on some videos. You know her a little bit. So if something major happens, I will let you know. But I just wanted to be honest and tell you that there were some bad things happening between us, and that definitely had a mental impact on me, and it was much more difficult to train during that time. And while I did not want to admit that straight away, and it was not just about that, I think it had a big influence on my overtraining, and now it's getting better. Aside that, training continues, and I will continue to be smart in my training, continue to train smart. As I said, this week I'm going to take it much easier, much lighter. Tomorrow, many of you asked to show how the classes specifically look, how the course looks. So tomorrow I'm going to do a live stream, 5:30 a.m. Well, that's obviously PDX, Portland time. So you guys are all over the world. Maybe that suits you better. Or maybe just wake up with me at 4:30. Sweet Christmas. So just wake up at 4:30, check in at 5:30, watch me train. I'm gonna show you around the gym. I'm gonna just sometimes put the camera just so you could see how it begins, the class, how it goes and how it ends. And yeah, you'll see the whole thing, and then you can have a feeling for how that training feels. And obviously that video will stay if you are not in the live stream itself. That video will stay and you can watch it later and just skip through it. Feel free to do that. But if you want to just get a glimpse in it and write hi, do that. And also there's a new thing. I don't want to push it by any means, but it's a cool thing. Since I moved to the States now, I got an option to add contributions through the so-called super chat on YouTube. So when I'm going to do the live stream, a new feature, you'll see this small dollar sign. That's where you can contribute. You can support me by sending a couple of bucks or a dollar, which I would really appreciate, but obviously don't stress it. But yeah, if you want to support the channel, if you want to support my work, that's going to be a great option to do that. Aside that, it has a function. Like if I would be there next to the phone, and I'm going to do that sooner or later, and I'm just going to talk to you and do a live stream, and then you chat. When you pay more, the more money you pay, that's the system, the higher, the more your text, what you wrote highlights, and it's like sticks there for a while, depending on how much you paid. I mean, contribution is a contribution. I think that's what's most important to me. But But then it's this nice feature, so that's not gonna be much use when I'm gonna train. I'm not gonna be around to read all the comments, only later. But yeah, if you wanna support my trip, for sure, you can do that in the super chat tomorrow. But it's not a, just about that. I hope you get that. So last exciting thing, Coach Vanessa, who I mentioned about, who you saw in a couple of videos already, we decided to do a barter, and I'm gonna help her out with her YouTube channel, just to boost it up to the next level. So I'm gonna share whatever we're gonna do with her on her channel, so you guys could check it out and let us know how good it is. In return, she's gonna do some private coaching with me. We're talking mainly so far about MMA because she's awesome at everything. She's a brown belt in jiu-jitsu, I believe, a former pro MMA fighter. She's awesome. So she's gonna teach me personally extra sometimes. Yes, I'm very happy about that. So I'm sure I'm gonna make a video. We're gonna make a video of that, probably publish it on her channel, but you'll still see it. I think that's a nice addition and that's gonna help me super boost my training without overtraining. Course. Anyway, that's it for the day. Let me know if you have some questions, comments. I always read them, as you know, especially in the first couple of days. So do it, write me, and I will connect with you later. And I wish you to own your journey as always.